Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Travelers Podcast, Episode 7. My name is Logic Mage.
I'm SuperQGS.
And I'm Brambler.
This week we're joined by a very special guest, the soda wielder himself, Pepsi Boy.
What's up? Welcome to the podcast, everyone.
Yeah, hello, everybody. So Pepsi Boy, do you want to introduce yourself? Some people might not know you, seeing as you're not exactly the most active member around.
Well, I'm the legendary Pepsi Boy. First person to ever reach level 100 twice, 100% legit player. I haven't been playing much recently because Taraga Dude has done me dirty, but that might change. But I'm excited to see what the community has done in my absence.
And we'll definitely get into a lot of that. But Pepsi Boy, do you know anything about the recent debates about the spawn fish?
No. So, I'm pretty sure I found the first fish, though. Like the first one ever.
It wouldn't surprise me if you did.
Probably. But the spawn fish is there's, you know how there's like the fish that's at 00, like right next to it?
I think so.
So there's been some debating, particularly from Lightning WB and some other people, saying that it's actually Spawn Australia. And this has been going on for way too long. It's been debated a lot more than it has any right to be. But recently, Trydude has just confirmed that it is indeed a spawn fish. Giving us the big W.
Do you have a picture of the spawn fish somewhere?
Yeah, so it is canon. The reason this has kind of been debated for so long is that there was a bit of a schism right when the game started, because given the new seed, the fish was still there, but its tail was severed from its body. So some people thought that the severed tail now represented New Zealand, which of course is completely ludicrous now that we have confirmation from the guy with one eye himself.
Well, I guess the one with, like, the tail severed does kind of look like Australia a little bit, but if you have, like, the full tail and everything, it's definitely a fish.
Yeah, I
agree. All right, get him off the podcast. No, I'm kidding.
So, yep, no more arguments. If I see one more person mention Australia in the Discord, they will be getting a perm ban. So, you guys, this debate has now been settled.
Logic. Then we would actually control the media and be tyrannical.
Oh, dang.
We can't actually start banning people.
Can't make claims like that.
Alright, so next up on the topic list is something we just got done with, like, 15 minutes ago, which, Brambler, you were kind of leading it, so if you want to talk about that, you can.
Yeah, so we're having a community chess tournament. We had 12 people sign up, which doesn't make for an even bracket, so we did, like, qualifiers today. So now we're down to 8 people. It should have some fan favorite people like Taraga Dude in it. Lightning WB will be in it. I'll be in it. Yeah, should be fun.
I'm pretty awful at chess. I think I just lose instantly if I join.
What's the format called, Zookly? It's like the 7-4 format?
We're doing a... Well, for the actual matches, people have 10 minutes in total, so they have more time to think. And
okay. But for these matches, the way we had it organized was such that each person's map, or the turn countdown was set to 7 minutes. Every move they make increases the timer by 4 seconds, so they constantly had to be on their toes and just making moves in an optimal way, just to keep the match rolling, right?
Yeah,
because we had a lot of matches to get through.
Anyway, it was fun. It might even be wrapped up by the time this episode comes out. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, it's been fun.
It all depends on when everyone's available, right? So,
yep.
So that should be the next community event, at least at the time of recording, which should be a lot of fun. Next up on the topic list is something that I have been working on with Mr. Lightning WB. Is we had the idea that we could make a giant wall around an area and have kind of a smaller scale game of the Travelers in a Hunger Games or Survival Games type style. So we've completed the superstructure. And it's, I think it's like 250, it's got a diameter of, a square diameter of 250. So, sometime soon, probably after the chess thing, we'll have a big Hunger Games tournament. We'll just be last person standing, and we'll probably have like storage containers with different weapons around the map, and then you can loot houses and cities and stuff. Should be a lot of fun. I'm excited about it because I feel like it'll be a good chance to explore fighting metas, because there really aren't that many fights that happen regularly. So having a higher concentration of them should be really cool.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up too. I'm really excited, if for no other reason than the fact that another superstructure is finally in existence now.
Yeah.
Especially since walls have now been nerfed to the point where it's very difficult to get one of those up and running. But never doubt Lightning. He will always find a way.
He just was like, I was like talking about this idea, and he's like, we could do a wall. And I'm like, no, that's crazy. Like, that's impossible. And he's like, I can provide the rope. And he did. He just like brought so much rope. His botnet is insane. So we were able to get that up in like a few days. It was really cool. So we just finished the initial wall. We're going to, we still need to place like the starting area and then some different storage containers around, but it should be a lot of fun. It'd be cool if it could be like an annual, either monthly or bi-monthly thing where there's like a title that you can get, because we got to wait for the houses to refill, but it should be a lot of fun to do. Hopefully it doesn't get griefed, but we'll see.
There's no reason to think that it wouldn't be that, like, you know, it can be reused, presume, as long as it's not griefed at all, right? So honestly, I'd be down for that being a regular event, just having a miniature Hunger Games thing.
That'd be a lot of fun. I think that would get people used to fighting, which is something that I've been thinking about. I have very little practice with the combat mechanics.
Some people haven't like had a real fight at all, so yeah, should be good.
So it'll be a lot of fun.
Next up is Update Aquatic, which is the long-awaited 1.1 update, finally dropped. I think it was yesterday at the time of recording, so...
I haven't actually gotten a chance to mess around with the mechanics. Has anyone here gotten to do that yet?
No. If you're talking about the new building item, no. I saw it yesterday, got really confused as to what it even was until I clicked on it, and I was like, oh, I forgot about it, so...
It's also very expensive, so I doubt there's going to be a ton of, you know, water bases in the works, but we'll see.
It is going to be interesting. I think it might be... I can see it getting being made cheaper, personally, because it is really kind of ridiculous to make any kind of bridge or anything. But I guess that's how it's nerfed. You know, you can't have bridges being made to puzzle items or anything like that.
Pepsi Bar, are you familiar with what's being added in this update?
No, not at all. I'm assuming it's an item that you can build over water.
Yeah, I think we should kind of go into it just in case anyone else is not aware. It's a... I forgot what exactly it's called, but it's a platform that allows you to actually walk and place materials, or rather building materials, other you know, types of walls and storage units over water, which is really interesting. Main drawback being that it's very, very expensive to do, and the actual security of the base compared to just a standard land base is pretty questionable. So we'll see how that factors into base building.
Something I want to do is, because it takes 10 cycles to break, that's pretty short. So I want to make a spleef arena, and I don't think you can actually break it underneath another player, but it'll just be like, if you can't move, then you're considered out. So we could have like a spleef minigame inside of the Travelers.
A very expensive spleef minigame.
Yeah.
Yeah. It'll be very...
We would probably do one round.
Yeah, that's it.
Maybe two if we can...
Unless there's some way to efficiently bot it, but again, yeah.
I bet you if Lightning agrees to help out, we'll be fine.
New spawn restrictions. Every time we mention spawn or the wall, chat usually blows up for about an hour or two, and then I can never read anything, so might as well get this one out of the way. Taro is placing, yet again, additional restrictions on what you can and can't do when building near spawn.
I think I forget exactly what it is, but within 1,000 of spawn, you're restricted with how many walls you can place in one area. I think it's like within a certain amount, a certain square radius.
50. So it's within a distance of 60 tiles. You cannot place more than 50 tiles.
Okay.
Of the same wall area. So the idea is that this is going to prevent massive spawn structures, right?
Yeah, I think I really like this change. I feel like it's a good... You can still build stuff, you can still play science, you can still do a lot of things. It's just going to keep people from making giant structures around spawn specifically. You still have the ability to make superstructures. It's just we won't have all the issues that come with how the current system works.
It's also notable that with this change, presumably the wall that's already there, or at least what's still intact of it, is going to be kind of a deteriorating asset, right? There's no way that you're going to be able to replace anything that's already there, just because there's already so many, there's such a massive walls even in that little condensed area, so.
So if someone breaks a piece of the wall, you're not actually going to be able to place that back, at least until it's broken enough to where it's underneath 50, and at that point it's just going to be completely gone.
So recently, after some upgrades, updates, whatever, the server ended up becoming 2 TPS or something along those lines, or it was running the same like process twice or something. So basically the game's running at twice the speed it should have. You're gaining XP at twice the speed you should have. This only happened for about a like actual day. Then it was fixed quite briefly, and now the server is also being upgraded to handle like botnets, etc. Like just, you know, make sure the server is more stable in the future so we don't keep having problems with the TPS and such.
I think specifically what was happening was Lightning's botnet was sending, I think, 4 packets a tick, and it was not able to handle that many packets each tick. So Tor actually was testing some stuff, and it seems like there's some kind of optimization with encryption that each packet does, where it has to decrypt the package. And I think that's what was causing the CPU to go like to 100% really fast. So I think he might actually end up downgrading again, because he doesn't need the whole thing, if he can find a way to make that more optimized.
Yeah, otherwise he's currently paying $40 a month for the server, which is quite a bit.
Probably more than he needs to, if he can optimize it. But yet again, Lightning WB breaks the server, as is Traveler's tradition now.
I think there's just something new every episode we talk about with him. I'm sure he enjoys us mulling over everything he's done in these episodes too. But yeah, I think aside from that, that is pretty well everything that's happened within the last 2 weeks. No puzzle developments, as far as I'm aware. Although, definitely did release a fan clue, which I think is still unsolved.
I'm gonna have to look at that later.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to link to that or something. But yeah, this is where we're kind of gonna launch into the main topic, the meat and potatoes. And this is a little unconventional, as far as our, you know, podcast goes. We usually don't kind of delve into visual aspects like this. But we're going to be taking a look at every single Traveler's fan video in chronological order, along with Pepsi Boy, and we're going to be kind of giving some insights and kind of behind-the-scenes info on all of them. So the videos will be on screen, and you'll be able to follow along. I don't know if we have permission. I think all of us are... the vast majority of these videos are actually created by the four of us. I think one or two of them might be from other sources.
I think all of them are, actually.
Yeah, all of them are.
Oh, maybe. Never mind, then. Again, reason why we got Pepsi Boy on here. And, like, when I say Traveler, when I say fan videos, you know, this isn't, like, a completely exhaustive list. I know there's stuff from, like, James and whatnot, but, you know, like, if you take a look at those videos, they're not exactly what we'd really consider to be in the style of...
These are the edited
videos. Yeah, you know, videos. Not like, you know, 10-minute long rap. I don't know. I don't know what you call it. Like the 10-minute long diss tracks.
Wait, unscripted.
What? You know what?
Do you not maybe, know? Maybe honestly, about
maybe we
James?
Should just watch one of those and see what Pepsi Boy.
I'm kind of interested now.
Yeah, now he is.
Well, at the end, we gotta show Pepsi Boy.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know if we'll do it on the podcast, but we will be showing.
Yeah, we can't. Okay. Because he's on
we can't do it on the
he,
podcast.
Yeah, he shouldn't
after
even
this.
Be on YouTube. So okay. Yeah.
Yeah, actually, that's true. We'd probably get arrested somehow, but
yeah. I don't think we would be arrested, but we might get a TOS strike.
Alrighty, so the first video we're going to be starting off with, this is the very first Travis fan video ever created. It's called Automatic Vortex Builder on the Travelers, Foco on Top. This is by Pepsi Boy. So let's take a look at it. Alrighty, so... Pepsi Boy, do you want to tell us a little bit about the development process behind this masterpiece right here?
Alright, so as you can see, you got the nice gif of Taraga Dude sipping a Pepsi. Classic of all the ages. I got some Taraga tunes in the background. And this epic script for auto vortex building. I'm pretty sure I just downloaded some macro recorder and then recorded myself building the vortex and then like added some stuff to like make it go over a couple tiles. So you could just infinitely build vortexes going into the left. I only built a few because I didn't have that much items on me there.
Well, you had a lot of sticks.
Yeah, a lot of sticks, a lot of cloth. In the next video, I ended up using up most of them, but this one's just, like, showing off the ingenuity of the Vortex Coalition building some nice vortexes there.
This video is actually a bit dated because you can't do what he's doing anymore. You can't just put a singular stick in the a hole.
You can't do that?
No, well, you can, but it won't stay around, right? It'll get deleted by his it's like a item filter. Like, if you only put one or two sticks in there. Yeah. The actual value is changed. But you used to be able to just collect 150 sticks and then make whatever you wanted just out of sticks, so... you know, I kind of miss those times, but... It had to be changed because of, bots. They would just, you know, dig holes for EXP, leave a bunch of holes behind, and clog up the server database, so...
See, that's probably the official reason, but I think the real reason is Tarogi Dude was jealous of my Vortex and wanted to get rid of them.
Probably. Alright. There's nothing.
Okay. I think it's just the same thing for the... do you know which Tarogi Dude song this is?
No, I just took a random one off his...
Random one? It sounds familiar. I think he used to use it in his outro, right?
Maybe.
If I'm not mistaken.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Okay. Second Pepsi Boy video. I think this is the only other one, actually. Title is The Vortex Coalition Takes Over 420-911 on the Childers. Pokemon top, once again.
Please. What's going on, everybody?
Pepsi Lord 420.
Vocal on top. Vocal on top.
I like that sentence mixing.
Vocal on top. Vocal on top.
Yeah, see, it started off with the clip of American Oreo, and then now we got Fit MC. That's kind of wild.
Vocal on top. 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 Vocal on top.
As you can see, I used my Pro Vortex Builder to make a nice value of vortexes.
Yeah, it's quite expanded it quite a bit.
The legendary homeland of the Vortex Coalition, those coordinates.
If I recall correctly, sorry for interrupting you, but this actually got wiped with the world update, right? You had to expand a little bit.
Well, no. There was some issue, like, I'm not sure if it was related to this, probably not, but, like, he had to roll back the server, like, 24 hours or something, or 48 hours, and this got deleted. But before that, I actually met up with a bunch of, I posted the link to the game in the Vortex Coalition, a bunch of people came to those coordinates and met up with me there.
Oh, wow.
So it was pretty fun.
That's awesome, I didn't even know that. Volko really did be on top.
Yeah, at the time, I think that was probably the biggest structure, maybe. Thanks. Even though it was just holes. I ended up using, like, all my resources there.
If you went into the subreddit when you posted that there, it was actually, for a while, it was the most downvoted post.
Most downvoted? What?
Yeah.
Why?
Wait, before you move on, I think one of those videos is still the most viewed Traveler's video.
I think it's...
It's either...
Yes,
dang! Is that because of, like, Voco members that were reviewing it or whatever? You, like, just gave it to those? Dang.
I mean, I posted on the Voco sub as well. I got 200 Vocoin for making that bid.
Wow. How much is that worth?
Like 5,000 US dollars.
Wait,
you
really?
Serious?
No.
Okay. I don't know how the
is no official translation
works.
Rate, but it's a pretty nice sum of Vocoin.
Well, I mean, congratulations on your acquisition. That's cool.
Yeah, man, I got to spread the Travelers.
This third video, I have a lot of attachment to. I'm sure a lot of us do too as well. This was Bram's first Travelers video. It is titled "The Travelers: Tarogi's Turn in the Cage," and this documents our grand escapade to trap the developer within his own creation. So let's just give it a listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
We got him. So I remember we were just doing... initially we were just doing this for fun, right? We didn't think it was going to be all that documented or whatever. But then Brian was like, hey, you know, I'm going to record this so that we can make it in the video later. And I was like, yeah, okay, that sounds cool. I know that this kind of seems a little primitive nowadays, but I was not expecting editing of this magnitude at all. I wasn't expecting like all the screenshots to be going across, you know, telling the whole story. So that was pretty crazy to see. It's kind of kicked off the whole like large scale editing project, I think.
Yeah, this is really kind of the format of what most Traveler's content is like today.
Yeah, I...
Were you around when this was released, Super?
No, I was... I forget exactly when I joined. When was
you were Alpha, I think. This was pre-Alpha. Yeah. You could tell because of the building thing isn't even in there yet. This was the first building object you could use.
Yeah. I remember when the anchors were underscores. They were like that when I first joined.
Yeah.
But this was one of the first videos, this video is one of the things that made me really interested in the Travelers, because I could see like what it had to offer and just the cool things that you could do in it.
Yeah, I mean, even if you have no idea of what's going on, you can kind of say, oh, these guys are like, there's this huge plot that's going on, and, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was really happy with how this turned out. But yeah, like you said, it doesn't seem like that impressive like now, but...
No, I still
love I still enjoy watching it and, you know, reminiscing about it, but... yeah.
It's pretty fun.
We've one-upped it by now, but...
Oh, definitely.
I love this video.
So just to be clear, the people that were involved with that, it was myself, Bram, and Pepsi Boy. I think you might have seen him once or twice in that video, but he was not really shown prominently. But yes, he was involved with a lot of the process towards getting those
resources.
Shards. Yeah, he gave us
like all the batteries
some,
and wires.
Some,
and stuff.
I think it might have been just shards. I traded him some souls for shards or something like that.
I don't think I had any shards because like I came back from not playing the game just to.
Oh, sorry, not shards. The fragments. Yeah,
it was like it was like wires,
material fragment or something.
Yeah, we had a transaction.
And then you, wait, which of the two was it, like, group spawn? Was it Pepsi Boy or was it Logic?
That was myself. That was, like, a good day before it actually happened, too. So the screenshot you see in there, it's not actually the full, yeah, maybe, like, pan back to it. I actually added two more layers, and it took, like, an hour, just because I wanted to really dig it in there. Yeah, so it's, like, two entire more layers. It took it might have even been like three. I wanted to take a full minute in order to get to spawn, because in order to get there, you have to go into the event, which takes 3 seconds, click exit, which takes an additional 3 seconds, click in 3 seconds. So with 10 layers, it takes a full 60 seconds to actually get into the monument. So that was pretty funny.
Oh, because this was before it was changed to 1 TPS,
yep,
right?
That was back when the cycles took place over 3 seconds.
Wow.
So as you can imagine, the process of digging all those holes was extremely arduous, seeing as it took, if you're being completely optimal, it took 6 seconds to dig every hole. So.
I remember, like, I said, like, we should do that. And then I dug, like, probably, like, 10 or 15 holes, and I'm like, okay, this is boring, I'm done. And I, like, walked off to the side a little bit, and I came back, like, a few hours later, and there was, like, a giant thing. I was thinking, this guy really went hard.
Yeah. It's really persistent. Which is a shame, because it was wiped like less than 12 hours after, but we don't talk about that.
Drug dude always killing our phone.
Yeah. It was obnoxious, like, it was a threat, though. Like, it was horrible.
Yeah, that was the point.
I felt bad. Like, I dug, like, a couple, but I felt bad doing it, and I was like, ugh.
Well, I guess my thought was like, well, I mean, I kind of feel bad. There's like, a baseline apprehension to doing it, but, you know, it's anarchy, so... That's what's gonna happen. Anyway, yeah, that's Trogdy Australian the Cage. A lot of stuff you can kind of gather from that, but still very primitive. Next one is, okay, this is the... How far was this between this and the other video?
This is from May.
So this was on the 5th of May.
And the
okay,
other one
so
was March
just
6th.
About 2 months. So this is his, this is Bram's second video. So this documents us finding one of the puzzle pieces in pre-release. So I think it kind of goes over this in the video, but PFG found this. Before this point, there was actually no way you could find these. Given a clue, you couldn't actually decipher anything and just find one. You had to find them at random. So The only reason we actually found this was because PFG's bot was just kind of wandering around and like, oh, there's a triangle over there. So that was what started the whole thing.
I'm actually really happy with this one, too. I think, like, the intro to it was great.
Yeah, that's good.
Alright, here we go.
Oh, you see that, like, old splash art, too? Yeah. I like this pan. This is good. This is well done. Okay, hold on. Pause the video. Did we ever find the second secret location? Like, do we know what that is?
That is the trapdoor. That was the trapdoor.
Okay.
Were at it.
Okay. I think. When did we find that? What, like, was it? How long was it after we found this? The triangle that we actually were able to locate the trapdoor.
I have no idea, dude.
I think it was like around a month, or at least it was a fair few weeks after that. Because
it was a while.
Yeah. Because even though PFG was constantly digging holes, I guess he must have been, I don't know, maybe the chances were different, maybe he was just unlucky, but it was a long time before we actually found that second location, so. Anyway, just a little side note there. You can see PFG's holes around too.
Yeah. That's how I know I was close. I felt
exactly.
Like
that's how you know he's nearby, right? You can just see his little trails. I love this clip. So I made that GIF as well. Brad put it in the video. There it is.
Oh boy, I remember I was so disappointed.
I think PFG also confirmed after the video came out that he didn't receive any XP from discovering it, supposedly.
Yeah, no, apparently it didn't give XP because, well, it killed you, so.
So, do you want to go into why you were disappointed initially?
Yes, let's do that. Because this probably doesn't make sense without context, does it?
Yeah, so we have PFG put out this location. We go up to it on, like, fresh alts, right? So we didn't really have items, and it just didn't, there was nothing there. Like, it was just some quick text, and that was it. And it didn't really, like, say anything. And
you also have to keep in mind, this is at a point in the game when the puzzle isn't out, right? So there's no, like, overarching objective. Just kind of survive and find all those secrets and stuff. So at this point, we've already explored like all the cities and found all the secrets and stuff. So at this point, we're like, dang, new content! Like, you know, it's just like super rare location that took this long to find. And suddenly, PFG's like, yeah, just go ahead and look at it. I don't really want to go back all there. And then we get to it, and it's just this little little thingy. Like, it's not this kind of massive secret little thing that has all this tons of lore that Taragadu promised, and it's just this stupid little pyramid. So what's up with that? That was our mentality at the time.
And then that goes into the pyramid's true purpose, part two.
Right. So this is the amended part two. After you'll see what Taragadu's had to say in response to that video. So it's kind of funny because he basically told us off for like not trying to look into it at all. Where the clowns?
I remember when I said I found the location too, he said, oh, I doubt he actually went there.
Yeah, because he expected you to have interacted with it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he would have seen. So that was kind of our clue there too. That there was something.
Yeah, I was very confused as to why he had so much doubt. But...
So you can see there's two guys there. One of them is me, one of them is Toro. He wanted to actually, he teleported there just to certainly see what's about to happen, so. I love the editing on this one too. I think as you're about to see. Right, so here it is. This is what he was expecting to see. This event also occurred during the actual pyramids post-release. Everyone got that notification whenever a pyramid blew up. So that was kind of our first taste of a global event, which I'm sure is going to happen again at some point during the modern puzzle.
And then you guys troll everyone saying that there was nothing.
Yeah, that was awesome. What was awesome too is that I don't know who it was, but somebody actually went to that location just to check that nothing
was
there.
That was me. No.
Yeah.
Yoffe. Hold on, it's in the
video at the end. And they couldn't find anything, so they thought we were being serious. Oh god. Plumber.
I think after you, I can probably find a screenshot of this actually. But when I got there, I just buried a shard and I put a sign that said, "Rest in peace, here lies Bramblery and Super QGS's hopes and dreams."
I never went back to it, so that's funny. Pepsi Boy, were you playing around this time or no?
I think so, but I don't think I was online for that.
Okay, I'm curious to see if you've seen any of the ones past this too, because I think it starts to get a little more, I don't know if this, past this point, I think we were in beta, so we'll see.
Well, next one, I think, let's see.
He would have been around at least until, the Logic Brand Pepsi Base video, right? So.
Yeah, I thought that was next, but, okay.
Okay, so he probably would have seen this too.
This is where the lawnmower meme originates from.
So this is Super's only, actually, I shouldn't say only, because there's been a few other ones, but like, you know.
My only edited.
Yeah, you know what I mean. So let's give it a watch.
Pickaxes are basic. You should use something cool like a chainsaw. That's a cool idea. But that would imply needing fuel. And I'm not going to require things that need fuel right now. Probably just an axe.
These streams are now private, by the way. This is like the only proof these ever existed.
A chainsaw than a lawnmower.
Yeah, I wish he would unlist them and then link them somewhere. That would be cool.
Yeah. No, I wish he had like them in a playlist or something. I love all the music and stuff here too. I think this is pretty underrated.
Yeah. So he started the fight before I could say anything.
This is my first ever
fight. Long so I clicked machete, and it didn't start, and I was confused, because I didn't know I had it set ready. So I'm scrolling around. And then I see the countdown timer, so I go to another tab to finish what I was saying, but I didn't realize that Tarragadu could start it already, so I missed the first attack.
Okay, so pause the video real quick. So if you go back just a second, you'll actually see that even if you had clicked the button, which I don't know if you did or not,
I don't think I did.
Even if you did, heavy attack beats block, so it would have been the same result either way. But still, you had a reduced amount of time to actually consider what you had to do there. So
yeah.
Yeah.
But this is my first ever fight, and I didn't know what was going to happen. So I went into Discord to talk smack, and then that lost me my first round. I probably make so many bad decisions here because I have no idea what I'm doing.
There's one very devastating one at the end that you'll see as well.
This is back before I used the Discord application. I used to use my browser.
Why?
I don't know.
Scared. Okay, so yeah, he runs out of stamina. Taro obviously goes for the heavy.
Yeah, you can keep brainstorming Super TGS, but it's not going to be lawnmowers, and it's not going to be chainsaws.
I love the audio work too. Go so heavy. It's a good stream of consciousness. Guess I'm down to one. So Taro's like really in a corner. He has no stamina, no health.
I went for the heavy.
Goes for heavy. He goes for the heavy.
I didn't know what each thing did really, so I was pretty much just clicking random buttons. And that led to my downfall.
Yeah. Like, look at that. No stamina on Taro. One health. That was it.
And there's one thing at the end, I think. So that's the reason we don't have lawnmowers, and that's the reason we want lawnmowers.
So, let me ask you this, Super. Do you think if you won that, Taro would have actually added the lawnmowers? Do you think it's a matter of his word?
Sure, lol.
He did say. He did say he would.
So, okay, lawnmowers were, like, not really a meme before this video. Because it was like a one-off joke that I said in the live stream. But it wasn't like a meme that would like keep saying. But after this video, it became an actual meme. So I do think that like if I won this battle, he actually would have done it. Because he said sure.
Taraga dude does like crushing our hopes and dreams though, so who knows?
I would have passed him.
I don't think he would say. I think if he lost, he would have done it. But I also had no... That was my first ever fight. He actually teleported to me to do it.
Yeah, I think he really wanted to test out fights that day. I did reference this. It was the exact same day that fights got added as well.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty sure we're all very inexperienced towards it. This is probably the last video that Pepsi Boy would have seen before he stopped playing. Oh, aside from Journey, yeah. But like, you know.
I don't, yeah. I mean, also it was a bit slow, so I'll probably just like skim out.
Okay, that, yeah, it's probably is not like a... Well, we'll probably have a little bit to say, but it is a bit of a long video.
Yeah, I'll skim it. It's very slow, but... I mean, it worked for the video, but... Well, there's the base.
I like how this looks just so tiny compared to, you know, whatever the superstructures people are building nowadays, but this is kind of before bots were standard for making that sort of stuff.
I like how that became the official name. I just randomly said Logic Brand Pepsi Base 420. But you can put images on signs?
No, that was me censoring out the password.
Yeah, using Trog Clone.
Okay.
You know, Logic had an actual name for the base, but I forget what it was.
I wanted to call it the Armored Abode, because it's like this little tiny but very, you know, it's got the two layers on it. This is a very well defended thing, right? But then I think Pepsi Boy said that once in a public chat. It's like, you know, whatever name we chose for it, Logic Brand Pepsi Base 420, and that was what stuck.
You know, I mean, I like Logic for M Pepsi Base more than, you know, the armor of the boat. No offense, Logic, but, you know, Pepsi Boy just has a certain naming.
This is the point when anchors got changed, too.
Also, this is before, because this was pre-release, there was no, small spoiler, there was no boats. So if this base existed now, it would be the easiest thing to break into. But at the time, there was absolutely no way to get across water, so that's why it was just one wall was just completely indestructible.
Right. We're very rich too.
Yeah. But wait, there's more. And then we have this bit at the end.
Okay. I don't think we ever explained that. We should probably just go over there real quick. The reason why there's a hole there, it was not intentional, as you might have inferred. The reason was because you were trying to set that up, and it was very difficult to coordinate just through text. But the reason that the wall didn't place was because There was something buried there, and I think Graham just put something there and forgot about it or whatever.
No, I didn't realize you couldn't build over it, so I just buried it real quick so I would have enough room in my inventory for the walls. And then I put it right there and not realizing, and then it messed it up. I was so mad, though. I was...
Yeah, because we were spending, like, we only had, like, 10 walls to do that trick there, so we messed it up, unfortunately. So, I guess he kind of tried to rectify it by turning it into a joke, but it's just kind of, it looks a little out of place. Yeah. So here we got our obligatory Castlevania reference. We had to coordinate this game such that he was dying, because...
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
There's Super Mario. I remember I was like, I was asking Graham, what do you want me to build? And he was just like, just put some random stuff down.
Yeah. I mean, it looked fine, so.
That was the part when we leaked our coordinates. Leaked in quotations. And that was when we had the party. The party is recorded. I think Bram probably still has the raw footage of it.
I still have all the raw footage from this game. I plan to start releasing it a bit, but we'll see.
The thing is, we planned to make it a video, but it was like a good hour long, and it was going to be very difficult to edit. So a lot of that made it into this video right here, but it's obviously not the main focus.
I have a lot of screenshots and footage and things. That I think there's a lot of unreleased stuff that could be edited, but could be really cool if it's released.
Oh, what was cool about this, too, is that not only that, but he also had, like, the spawn massacre that occurred after sleeper kills were added in. That was in here as well.
Yeah.
So it was just a compilation of a bunch of stuff, including stuff that was already out and things that were previously unreleased at this point. So I think most people watching this are probably aware of what the context of this was, but... The idea is that this is sort of a tribute to everything that happened in the game before release. So it was sort of a pre-release memoriam that we could kind of look back on and just see, oh, yeah, I remember this. I remember when I did that. So, yeah, I guess we'll just play the video.
This is my favorite Traveler's video, by the way.
It is my favorite as well.
It's
very special to me.
A few months ago, an idea hit me. What if we combine the best elements of an anarchy MMO that is text-based and story-driven with a huge interconnected puzzle that could take years for players to solve?
All right, so the idea here is that it's the that was the very first video that Taro did on it. Version 0.0.0. I think that might have been before the game came out. Was it something about it?
Yeah, I mean, it was the only logical place to start the video, in my opinion.
Yeah, obviously. There he is. I remember that.
First conversation.
I knew deep down that was going to be important somehow. There he is. Hey, this looks familiar.
Targeting to go on super fast there.
Yeah.
I really like the Pepsi game.
Right, there's my art. That was scary. That was the only time. That fun fact, I probably played this game. I put more active hours than probably anyone in this game. That was the only time I ever got softlocked. Like, regardless of being in post-release or pre-release.
That's really impressive.
I know it's happened a few times to some other people, but...
I think that's only happened to people that have, like, weird clients or mods or something, though.
That's true. Oh, yeah, here it is.
I remember I made sure to get, like, the moment the server went down.
Yeah. We had to, like, coordinate this very, very precisely. Somehow we found Toro immediately, too. I don't know if we, like, organized it with him, but he just happened to be there.
No, I think he teleported to us or you or something.
Oh, maybe.
Oh, is that when he added killing and we went, like, massacred everyone?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was super glitchy, well.
We don't mention this in the video, but this was, like, the whole player stack. That's kind of outside of the range of this discussion, but that was a whole other thing. See, we're getting here too. That was when he found the base, using his little bot.
Yeah.
Went over the oceans. Right, and this one's the base tower. Here's the party footage as well. How many people? I think it was like a good six or
we
seven.
Had like seven, eight.
Mm-hmm. And when was I invited?
Oh, that was when we showed off the teleporters. Well, everyone cut
yeah,
straight.
Yeah, I mean, you weren't invited, I think.
I think everyone was.
I don't think you were like playing. Right,
I didn't get the memo.
I'm sorry, Pepsi Boy.
These are our personalized messages. Super included a very tongue-in-cheek hidden message in his, if you wanted to decipher that.
I couldn't figure
it out. I didn't
notice
honestly. It either. But Taro did, apparently, and he was not very happy.
Oh, I think I have a message in here.
Oh, God.
This image is very interesting.
That's from, like, a stream way back. Can't remember who drew that, but it's pretty epic.
I think the funny part about this is that we didn't end up meeting at the monument.
No, we got separated because some of us spawned a little further away. We immediately went to the sepulcher, rather. But yeah, I remember when this probably sounds terrible, but when I saw this the first time, I was, it was very moving, I'll say. It kind of touched me in that way because I got to see all these little things that had been kind of put in motion all those other months. So I love the song choice
really,
too. I think I might have been the one who suggested the song. I think it's called End of the World or End of a World by Porter Robinson. So video is copyright claim, but whatever.
This podcast is getting copyright claim, but like,
oh yeah, definitely. Unless we mute that, which we probably won't. But
no, it's fine. But okay. Yeah, no, this podcast is getting claim.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really dug, like, for a lot of stuff. It was kind of hard because it was really only me that was making, like, videos at the time. Like, Pepsi Boy had a couple, and Super had the one. But, like, most of it I had to, like, try to, like, make it make sense through these, like, pictures, which is kind of...
Yeah, especially if you're not, like, really into the community side of things with this game, it's probably a little hard to... It is at the pace where you can probably read it, but it is going a bit fast, so... But I really do think you struck a good balance there with everything.
Yeah, I spent hours on this. I mean,
it's a really good video. It's definitely my favorite video.
Alright, what's next? Oh, chain reactions.
This might be my second favorite video.
From here on out, everything is post-release. we've been at this for a while, so I don't think we'll try to speed anything up, but it is just kind of goes to say how much there is to talk about these. So yeah, so this is my first Travelers video, one of two, and this was a documentation of our journey to Stop Slippy. I do think in terms of the narrative, this is probably the strongest one, because there's actually a very like defined story that you can kind of try to follow, even if it is very rapid fire. But I am still very proud of this one. This is my very first public YouTube video, actually, because I had edited some stuff before, but it wasn't like anything I really wanted to share. But I am very proud of how everyone's kind of reacted to it, and
it turned out amazing.
Yeah, so thank you.
Have you seen this one yet?
I mean, I haven't seen like, any of these videos. Well,
okay, should be interesting. Yeah, let's go to watch.
It's a lot of theories.
Wait, those texts.
An urge pulled the mind toward the southwest.
Southwest? I got a message.
Oh, yeah.
No. No, we have to go back to the Black Pyramid?
Well,
do we want to pause here?
Sure.
I think, okay, I'm sure we talked about this in the episode 2 or whatever, but I do want to reiterate kind of how this kind of played out, right? So we went to Clue 3, which is at the bottom left. And you interact with the pyramid and it gave you the clue. And that was how you went to the other, I think they're called spires, the other four spires, and destroyed them. Then you had to go all the way back. So at that point, we're like, well, this kind of sucks, because now we have to spend an additional week just walking there and getting whatever we need to get there that's now appeared. And Slippy comes along and says, hey, I'm already like very close to there. I could just go in there and just get it for you. So that was how this whole thing started. Because it's this one dude that said, yeah, I'll just go ahead and give you whatever you want, so. That was why you heard my audible reaction at the start there. We have to go back to the Black Pyramid. It was agony.
Have until about 7:03, I think, actually.
Let's do it. I'm scared too. I had to revise this whole section because initially it was
based on the screenshot.
It was some clips and it kind of made sense, but it didn't really. If you weren't familiar with what was happening, it wasn't distinguishable at all. But it was definitely worth in the long run because you kind of get to see this. I love the production of this as well, because you kind of get to show off all these little, stuff you cheap super would make and share on the private chat. It just made me laugh, and I get to kind of show it to everybody. Yeah. Yeah, stuff like this, right? You could just never convey with, like, a little text document or whatever. As soon as I saw this raw footage as well, I was like, oh, this is perfect.
This video is just so devastating. Because each wall takes
an hour.
Like 8 hours to break.
I don't know about 8. I think it's it's about, for wood walls, it's about 1.
It is? Okay.
That's with the sledgehammer though. It might have it's shifted a lot over a while, so.
Thank you. Right now, actually, I just broke it. Right now, it's 6 hours with a sledgehammer. I'm pretty sure it is it.
Okay, so I think it would have been different back then.
You keep there. I'm gonna go patrol out there. You keep an eye on the door and the two holes. We did it. There's the monument.
Alright, whatever happens, guys. I'm proud of all what we were able to accomplish here.
For anyone wondering, that was, in fact, 1 a.m. I did stay up to watch that. I like this map, too.
Yeah. It actually got more completed. The right side, it went farther up the right side, and then it went all the way down to the bottom left corner.
Right.
I didn't have a world download of it, but before it was... That's like it was filled in all that way before it was like the rest of the wall was taken down.
I think Lightning probably has some of it on his modern map. I think some of it's probably got deleted by now, but yeah.
Yeah, Lightning has like a more recent, like what it looks like now, where you can see a lot of it.
Pepsi Boy, are you familiar with the wall removal controversy?
Maybe not the controversy, but I'm familiar with the wall because when I came back a few weeks earlier, like my accounts were on the bottom right, but my base was at the top left, so I had to go like through spawn, and like all of them got stuck in the wall like at different parts, and it took me forever to get out because like I was on like the bottom right edge, right, and then I like walked inside the wall, and I'm like, okay, I'm out of it finally, and then I hit the other side, and I got even more stuck.
So I'm actually curious because, I mean I might bring this up a bit later, but. The short story is, Trogadude removed, like, the vast majority of all of what you see here. We'd intended to fill it all in initially, but it ended up getting removed before we could actually go through with that. So, do you still play 2B?
A little bit.
Okay. So, as an Anarchy player, what's your perspective on stuff like this? Like, when you see this, do you think, oh, is that just, like, how the natural course of the game goes? Or is it, it's kind of like, oh, they shouldn't be, this isn't, like, the main priority of the game. They should be focusing on, the primary experience, which is, like, the puzzle and stuff.
Well, I think when you have an environment like this where you can do anything you want, it's inevitable that players are going to end up doing something like this just to mess with other people. I don't really mind it. I mean, it's annoying for me walking through, but... In total, I think it's fun, and I think it adds to the experience of the game, I'm pretty sure.
That was kind of our perspective, too.
There's, I think today, a lot of the southern wall is kind of fragmented, but still there is a pretty cool landmark, which, although I was kind of upset about the wall initially being taken down a lot, I think it's cool that there's still a decent landmark there.
Yeah, you can still see some of those larger chunks.
Okay, there's only two more after this one.
It's fine. Alright, we're in this sort of long haul. Ready, so this is Fight Night. Bram, do you still consider this like a filler video, or is it just kind of like, yeah, this is alright?
I mean, I think it turned out fine, but like, I didn't put like a lot of effort into it. Like, it wasn't something I...
That makes sense.
That's the bunch of time, though. I think this is the first time I beat Toro getting on a fight too on this game, so...
That's pretty good.
By the way, Toro favors heavy attacks. He's probably in heavy attack right now. How did I know?
You know, so be careful.
I don't know, I think I tried to, like, cram too much in.
So, he does a lot of damage, but he also loses a lot of stamina. He's using Shovel? Holy cow. That's like, it's a gangster mode.
So how much, he has, what, he's running 80 stamina with a shovel, so...
That's 90 stamina.
Oh, sorry, I can't read this on my low resolution monitor. It is 90 stamina, okay.
Nice, go with heavy. Actually, maybe don't do that.
So for anyone who's not familiar, Shovel is probably one of the worst weapons in the game, but for whatever reason, I guess that's like the only thing Taro has.
He has to play
defensively
again, otherwise he abstains for every turn. He should go every other attack left or right.
Nice.
I keep getting confused when people talk in the video, because I think they're
actually... Yeah, that's probably going to be annoying for the viewers, too.
Good.
Something I want to petition for is to have more weapons, because there's no reason for the crowbar not to be a weapon. And then having a metal detector be a weapon would be just awesome as a gangster weapon.
Yeah, good read.
Yeah, because you can use the shovel, right? Why not the fact that you can't use the crowbar doesn't make any sense. And like, as of now, it's pretty polarizing, right? You only have, like, the machete's valid, the axe is arguably better than the machete. That's kind of it.
Really?
Yeah. If you look at the statistics.
What are the statistics of the axe versus...
So the axe is significantly less taxing on stamina than the machete, even though it does do less damage. I think it's actually more efficient if you look at the just kind of like the ratios and stuff. Yeah,
I didn't know that. I'll have to use that though.
I guess if you're like going for one shots or whatever, machete's probably better, but like, you know, it's situational.
Still think the spoiler warning boat should be a weapon that just drains all your stamina but does a ton of damage.
Super, our fight in this video was so long it wasn't even funny. Like, this fight was the reason I had trouble with the video, because like,
he's like cutting it and fast forwarding it, but it's still like 30 rounds.
It just went on and on and on. You wouldn't die.
I'm just too good.
I was trying this again. This just
I cut out the part where he said no.
We control the media. That's a lot of damage. This is very unorthodox fighting build. So he's running 40 base damage, which is insane, and no weapon. So he loses... he gets a minimum stamina penalty, which is minus 5. No bonus, but he gets... Again, it's plus 40, minus 5 on stamina, which is, like, ridiculous.
I'm
arguably
so
broken.
What did Rowan lose? He also chose heavy.
Yeah. Wait, why did I die? Yeah, I'm confused. I chose heavy as well. Did I? I don't know.
Yeah, you did. Unless the system didn't register it.
He said I chose too slow.
I like how the game even says you chose heavy attack, but it doesn't actually register. Not much I could do about it. So yeah, that's Fight Night. I like it.
Always drug, dude.
Rigged from the start against Longmores.
Pretty much.
I haven't actually fought a lot in this game. I think I fought Logic a few times.
Maybe. Yeah, I remember doing that in pre-release.
It's pretty
fun. I'd like to fight some more.
Anybody it's fun, although it is very stressful if it's like an actual fight.
Yeah, it's... the most fun fights I've had was probably against Allocator, because he's really good at it, and that's when a lot of stuff was on the line.
Dude, I remember Logic when you had your fight with him. You just went like dead silent for like 5 minutes. Like
I hate fighting with Alec because he is the most annoying playstyle like you could possibly have.
He gets in your head. Yeah, he's really good at getting in your
head. I can't really do it justice just by explaining it. You'd have to kind of do it yourself. But he has this really weird way of like. Yeah, he like knows what you're gonna do somehow.
Yeah.
I don't know.
He baits you like perfectly. Like it's.
And like you think like. You think you've got... It's like...
You think you got the upper hand, finally, and then you're just
like, you
dead,
think, like,
he
baits you, but, like, he baits you with, like, a fake bait, and then it's just, like, you overthink things, and it's crazy.
Oh, boy.
That was such a stressful night, because we lost the high-range teleporter, and...
Oh, wait, gosh, actually, that... no, we did get it back.
Eventually, yeah.
Eventually, but I did lose a fair amount of stuff. We had to like distract him and stuff. Anyway, yeah, we're getting off topic, but let's move on. Tipping the scales.
Should I like?
I think... Oh, sorry.
Should I have the whole dramatic rating, or should we skim
that? We'll see.
We can skim it a bit.
Yeah. If you want to listen to it again, you can kind of just listen. It's not a ton to comment on, I think, but this is also right. This isn't after the fact either, right? This is actually our live reaction, just me reading it.
Yeah.
So, are you familiar with this, enter the password. This thing, Pepsi Boy?
Do I need a password?
What would the password be?
Oh. Mundus.
Dividar Kata, right?
Dang. Oh, okay. I was about to say, I don't know if we mentioned this in the video or not, but, yeah, it is.
Here, wait. Bram, pause it for a second. So, I was on Zoom for my chemistry class, and I was just in another tab. I was just trying out different passwords to see if any of them work.
Yeah, you know, as you do.
And I figured it out in the middle of chemistry class. So I was actually not on this call because I was still in chemistry class, but I was like sending screenshots while they were all like waiting.
Oh, that sucked because we had to like, we couldn't react to a live, or we had to wait for Super to process all the information and give it to us or whatever.
Yeah.
Because I think I actually read it first, and then I probably should have just screenshotted it and sent it.
Alright, then the rest of the video is mostly just...
Yeah, again, if you want to listen to this, if you want to hear my Fit MC voice, you can do that. But,
there's a gag at the end, though.
Yeah, shall you watch that?
Wait, where?
Remember the lightning?
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh.
So, I knew, so once we figure this out, because... It was only Meep, Slime, Bram, Logic, and me that knew about this. And so I sent a screenshot to it to like tease it that we found something. And I knew that Lightning had a world download finder. So like he could look at an image and he could find where that was. He could find the coordinates of it. So before posting it, I intentionally like changed one of the text characters so it would throw it off.
It still cracks me up. You're like trolling as always. And then he just goes trying to run a shark. Okay, you know what really got to me about that too? Was because I hadn't. It was the fact that when he brought it up, it was only then that you actually said, oh yeah, I changed one of the tiles to it. Because you knew he was going to do that, right? Oh my goodness. I seriously cannot get over how funny that is. It's awesome. Alright, this is the final video. I like this one a lot. Waffles so, make super QGS.
Pepsi Actually, Boy, for some context.
Yeah, so you need some context, holy cow.
I solved the, was it the third clue? I forget which one it was.
Yeah.
I solved the third clue, and when you solve a clue, you get like a different colored name on the Discord. So I just said hi on the Discord and everyone flipped out. And then I started teasing that I would be doing a waffle stream, that Monday, and everyone knew that like by waffle stream I meant I would show off the clue, but then people started making jokes about like me making waffles on stream, and I just said a random, like, I was gonna be like, oh, I'm making a breakfast waffle stream because it was early in the morning, but then I ended up actually making waffles on stream, and this is the result of that.
Yeah, because at that point people were kind of pressuring him into saying, oh yeah, well now you gotta make waffles, right? Because you said you would. Otherwise, you're just a dirty liar, so this is the result of that. This is a highly edited YTP experience.
Logic made this one.
Yeah, I did it. You can also view this on, I forget which one, episode 5, maybe?
Something like that.
Something like that. You can figure it out.
What's happened to that?
Yeah. This is a little slightly extended version, though.
How's my mic?
Awful.
It's bad? Okay, here.
This is probably the most time I ever spent making one of those gags as well.
Oh, here we go.
Why is Discord being like this? Okay.
Very super.
You know, we got the quesadilla maker.
Nice.
I'm gonna start a fire, I swear. I don't think it is on. Alright.
So how do I do this? Two eggs. I only have one egg, but I'll deal. Oh, there's
eggshells. He'll do. Yeah, just dig them out.
So because I'm making waffles. It's day 32 in this FYI. You have, like, less than 4 minutes.
Alright. Speedrun waffle time. That is making noise. That is kind of scaring me. But I'm not going to get it.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
There's no paper towels! Holy cow. Maybe, actually, maybe that's not correct. I don't know.
You just don't start fire.
I'm, oh gosh, look at that, guys, here, one sec. That is a case.
You're really gonna eat that?
I don't even know if I want to touch it. I bet you I can, like, crack it.
I find like a bone crack sound effect. It was just the most horrific one I could find.
Image. I hate that.
Next week on the Travel Healers Cooking Show.
Okay, the waffle like melted to the microwave. It's like really soggy and there's like stuff on the bottom. Okay.
Wait a second.
I'm gonna clean this whole.
You didn't even put the waffle onto a plate. Oh, you just put it straight onto your glass rotating thing in the microwave.
Listen, he did. My mindset was okay. Cook waffle in microwave. Lightning McQueen plate does not go in microwave because it is plastic. And so then I just put the waffle in the microwave.
You don't have paper or glass plates or something?
I have other plates. I just forgot about them in the moment.
The heat of the moment, huh?
Oh my god. Well, and, that was a video.
Yeah. That was a journey, if you don't mind me saying. Jeez. I hope you enjoyed that, Pepsi Boy. Yeah.
Oh god. It's pretty cool.
I agree. But yeah, there's been a lot of videos, a lot of history, a lot of stuff to read about, a lot of stuff to watch, so I'm glad you could kind of join us on our journey to reminisce about all that stuff and just provide some commentary. So, thank you.
Yeah, these videos are pretty cool. I'm surprised, honestly, that people actually play this game so much. I guess Terraria Dude's good at attracting people like that.
Yeah, I think so. I'd love to see some other creators kind of take a stab at it, too. Like, if anyone else plays this game a fair bit and wants to take a crack at making some kind of edited history docs, right? I'm down for that.
Any traveler's video. It'd be...
Yeah, like if you put effort into it, I'll put it in the playlist, because this is, that kind of aims to be comprehensive, right? So.
Yeah.
But yeah, it is public, I think, or at least I think it is. I would have posted it in the lounge, if so.
We could probably put it in the description.
Yeah, we'll put it there too. We have two submissions from, or rather, no, we have two people submitting, but we have six questions, so
I'll let you decide. Yeah, the five probably go pretty quickly.
Yeah, okay. First question is from the guy with one eye himself, Trugadude.
It's, what do you think was the most controversial update that turned out to be good and the most controversial update that turned out to be bad? I think him removing the wall ended up being a good update, but
as much as I like to, as looks, you know, the meme and whatever about that, I don't think the wall is great for the health of the game in terms of attracting new players and making sense.
I agree. I think we made a whole podcast episode about it, but I think I do wish that he would have said that he was doing it first. But I think the auto breakers and just getting rid of the thin parts of the wall and poking holes in it was a good decision.
Yeah. I mean, even if we couldn't have, like, changed his mind on it, at least knowing that he was going to do it ahead of time would have made it stung less, you know? But
Think it was a good decision,
though. Yeah, it had to happen. In terms of the worst update,
I'm trying to think. Something that comes to mind that I don't think is perfect is the Axis. I feel
I'm still not 100% on that. Signs,
I feel
I agree.
What it should have done is it should have just made it so you can't build anything, but the things that existed wouldn't be deleted. And also, I think it should only extend out maybe, like, it could even be, like, 10,000 or something crazy. But, like, I was at the wall, and I had to, like, build over, like, on top of where the Axis slice was so I could put a sign there and stuff. But that's not even that big of a deal, honestly.
I don't know if there's really have been too many, like, bad updates, I guess. Like, they've all been at least, like, okay for the most part.
Yeah, I don't think there's any update that's been objectively bad. Except for, I think the one I'm the long term most salty about is the Axis one, as I said, because like there's some very historic signs that were on there, in addition to one of the first trapdoors we discovered as well was on the Axis. So
I don't even know if the Axis was that controversial, because like that's like the decision that we came to.
Yeah,
like,
I mean community. That's just kind of what stands out to me, right?
I just think that it could be changed a bit, but it's like it's not even like a big deal at all. I think it should just be shortened to not be all the way. But honestly, like that's the only thing that comes to mind, and it's not even a big deal. So good job, Taraga dude. Your game's pretty darn good.
Yeah, I agree.
Most controversial update, the one that renamed batteries to energy cells.
Uh-oh.
For sure.
Pepsi Boy, did you say that he did that just to spite you, apparently?
Yes, he did.
Nice.
Because I was asking for him to add, like, edible batteries or something like that. Or, like, the poo trails and shit like that. And he's like, no, we're not adding edible batteries. And they're like, you know what, I'm renaming the battery. No more batteries for you.
Darn. You do have a Pepsi bottle in the game, though.
That is true. You do have some lasting influence.
And that might kind of lead us into our next few questions from King of Black. Okay.
These are some interesting submissions. I think you'll like these a lot, Pepsi Boy. Where? Right. Okay. Got them here. All right. Question one. Which is better, Pepsi or Sprite?
Obviously Pepsi.
Okay. All right. That's an easy one, right? Let's go on to number two. This one's a little spicier. Which is better, Sprite or Coke?
Probably Sprite.
Okay, I can see that. Now, here's the big one, like the big, you know, this is the one to end all questions. Which is better, Coke or Pepsi?
Again, it would have to be Pepsi.
It's gotta be Pepsi.
Alright.
My opinion hasn't changed between the two questions.
Okay, then. Question four. I think that's the end of soda related questions. What are the first impressions of 1.1? I think we already kind of went over that, so we'll in the beginning. But
I
think it's pretty good.
Pretty good. Yep. I don't think it attracts anything.
Too expensive, but excited to play around with it.
I think they are a tad expensive. But yeah, I'm fully in support of pretty much everything that was added, aside from like maybe some of the spawn restrictions. But I don't know. I guess I'll have to see how that
plays out. Like the spawn.
I want to tell myself that I hate them, but like just because I'm in support of the full anarchy feel, but I guess I understand that's kind of a niche. I understand. Yeah, I get it. I know that's kind of a niche. Maybe that's not like because they were popular mentality, as I kind of discussed in the lounge chat a little while ago. But yeah. Final question.
Can I ask something? Has anyone messed around with the bridges yet? Can you build stuff on top of them?
As far as I'm aware, most of Lightning's botnet has been committed to building the super arena, the superstructure.
So I don't know if anyone's made any big things on water yet.
Yeah, but you can build.
I think you'll be able to.
Yeah, you can build on top of them, apparently.
Oh, you can. So, in theory, you could build a house in the middle of a lake and then like not have a little doorstep by your door. I mean, like, right. I mean, like, not have, like, a platform around it so people can't, like, take an axe and break it because you have to have the boat equipped to stay on the water so you could have, like, an unraidable base.
I guess part of the appeal, too, is that if you do make one of those, it's impossible for, like, a guy who just joined yesterday to actually break in because you have to have a boat. That's one of the main requirements.
Right.
Well, what you would have is you would have to actually build another bridge all the way to it in order to break in. So that would make it a lot more... The most secure bases will probably be built on water.
Yeah, I agree. It's just going to take a long time to make those.
Do you have to build the bridge from land, or can you just build it like in the middle of the water?
I think you have to build a bridge from land if you want to do it. Or on islands. There's islands. You can break... Yeah, you can actually... It takes only 10 seconds to break.
Oh, well. See, you could just build a bridge out into the middle of the lake and then destroy the bridge.
Yeah.
That's pretty interesting, I think, that adds some new base building meta.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I agree.
You could also teleport in with like a high range teleport, but that's expensive, and I still don't have a high range teleporter. Same. I have no idea how to get one.
Same.
I think there's only a few people that do.
I know they spawn in the Blasted City. I'm not sure if the other loot tables have chances to roll one, but that's just where I got mine, so I can tell you it got from... they do spawn there. It must be like a 1 in 100 chance or something.
I feel like a few people got it the first few weeks, but then no one else got it since then. So, I don't know.
Hmm. Final question. Would you be interested in listening to a Puppet Master podcast? This is pretty broad. I think if it was, like, kind of formatted in a similar way to what we're doing now, yeah, I'd listen to that.
I definitely listen to it.
But, however, my problem with it, and I think I said it, like, directly to Claw or Glack, that there's not enough, like, content being released for that game yet to have a consistent podcast for it, so...
Yeah, I think you said that maybe it'd be, like, once a month or something like that.
I think even that's too much, but...
Maybe.
I kind of disagree with you there. Oh, sorry, you go first, Pepsi.
It's like a different type of game, right? This one's more, like, community-based, and Puppet Master's more, like, single-player, so I don't really know what a podcast about Puppet Master would really entail.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They would just cover different development stuff, probably. I think after a month's time, you'd have at least, like, a few bullet points you could cover. Bi-monthly might be better, just because you would have more stuff, but honestly, I can see something like that being pretty cool.
I can kind of see over 2 months there being a lot of developments in terms of, like, new builds and new features and stuff, so maybe after that point, then it'll kind of start to be a consistent thing, but probably not until then.
I don't know if it necessarily needs to be a podcast, but maybe more of, like, a news video, just covering, like, everything that's happened in the last month in the Puppet Master.
Yeah, we can go and over. Honestly, that seems like the kind of thing that Trogody would be making himself at that point, like a devil.
Yeah.
So, maybe. But if it ever does happen, it probably won't be us. I'm not really interested in making a secondary podcast and maintaining all that, but if you're interested in it, then go right ahead.
I think it would definitely be really cool project, and I'd listen to it and be on if you'd want me on and all that stuff. Any message you want to send, Pepsi Boy?
Taraga, dude, I'll never forgive you, man. You really did me dirty. Deleted my Discord. He nuked it. I can't believe it. 3 years old, so much history there, and he just deleted all of it.
Do you want to give us some context on that?
Well, it was like an old Discord we made back in like 2017, like official FitMC Discord. Like, I'm pretty sure it was before Fit actually made one, or like when his got deleted or something, we made one, like pranked a bunch of people to join. And it was a pretty fun place, but like super inactive for like 3 years. But there was a lot of interesting messages from a Taraga dude. I'm not going to say anything to shame his name, but he had some interesting messages in there that are now lost to time, conveniently. Very interesting. Conveniently,
you wanted to cover it up?
Yeah, definitely a cover up from Taraga dude.
I remember that Discord.
Yeah.
You used to send it like you would send it like every once in a while, like anytime you saw someone, like after a FitMC Discord. Or maybe
it was probably me. Whenever somebody asked for the Fit Discord or Charlie Dude Discord, I'd send them that link. And it would just be like full of like obscene crap. Like they had like 1,000 NSFW channels for like every topic. There was like gore everywhere. I'm surprised nobody got terminated off of that Discord, but
yeah, it sounds like the kind of thing they would get nuked immediately, but I guess not.
Took 3 years for Taraga dude to realize he had some shameful messages in there and just had to just nuke the whole thing instead of deleting his messages. I won't forgive him though. I'll get my revenge one day, Taraga dude.
We'll have to organize another anchor trap project or something.
Yeah. Build in a lag machine.
Could you imagine?
How would you even do that in the Travelers?
Just have 1,000 accounts.
We just need to convince. See, all we need to do is convince Taro to add pistons, and then we're good.
Oh, that would be cool, actually.
He needs to add, like, a wiring.
Yeah.
Like, you can place wire on the ground to, like, open a door from afar or something.
Redstone update when?
That's, like, the only logical progression out of the aquatic update is electricity somehow.
That'd be a lot of fun. This is a way off topic, but a cool mechanic would be, that I would think, would be a base building mechanic where it's like an event. So you can like customize, like you know how in a city and stuff you can click to go from room to room? It would be like that, but it would be you could like write what you want in each thing. That's not really like probably going to be added, but it would be an interesting mechanic.
Yeah, it's like make your own little dungeons and stuff.
Or, like, maybe they would be preset, but you could customize, like, what rooms you want to have or whatever.
Yeah, once again, thank you, Pepsi Boy, for joining us. It was a pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, nice to be with you guys. Lots of cool vids.
Thank you.
Nice.
This has been the Travelers Podcast, Episode 7. Thank you for watching.
Peace out.
See ya.
See ya.
Bye-bye.